IRTS. So being in service and not being in service doesn't mean anything as far as knowledge is concerned. I'm not more knowledgeable than someone who has not qualified. It's not so. So even I also ask many of my friends who always used to get more than 20 marks than the cutoff. They also tell in Prelims they used to get 20 marks more than the cutoff. They also tell whatever I have done, they have done the same thing. In fact, they have done less things, okay, compared to me. So there is even now also I try to find a certainty. In the UPSC preparation, there is absolutely no certainty. So what works in UPSC preparation, as far as my own invention, is 99% hard work, and then 1% luck. And that 1% luck is like a limiting factor in a photosynthesis process. Limiting factor is that factor which is very much required in very trace quantities, but without which process will not take place. Like in photosynthesis, light is a limiting factor. Light requires in a very limited quantity, but without light, photosynthesis will not take place. It is like that. Luck is like light. 1% is needed, and that luck will come with 99% hard work. Very in exceptional cases, some unfortunate persons like me will not be having luck. For example, in this attempt, I had got 140 marks in the interview. Because of the bad luck, I don't know, because of my lack of preparation or wrong approach to the preparation. My written score were like 851, one of the top 50, top 40 or top 50. If I had got 10 more or 15 more marks in the interview, my rank could have been in top 55, like that. So it all luck factor works here, okay? But we have to focus on those things in which we have control. Luck is something which we don't, we cannot control. So we can control this 99% of hard work. So mera kehne ka matlab hai, 90 plus days are remaining still. That means 100 days exactly from today. So make a plan. Whatever you have studied or not studied, it doesn't make any difference now. From now onwards, what will you do? What will you do from the, today itself, fix a plan, like routine. This is very important. Morning to till you go to the sleep, you should follow a routine. There is a psychological identification that anything if to change our habit, it takes 21 days. Like for example, I am waking up at 11:30 in the morning daily. Consider that, okay? I want to wake up at 7 a.m. That means till today I have woken up at 11:30 a.m. in the morning. Tomorrow I want to wake up at 7 a.m. You have decided that you will wake up at 7 a.m. tomorrow. That doesn't mean that you will definitely wake up at 7 a.m. You will wake up at around 10 a.m. tomorrow, though you have decided to wake up at 7 a.m. But you should not give up. 10 a.m. next day it will come down to 9 a.m. next to next day it will come to 7 a.m. like that. And if you practice it for 21 days, on the next 22nd day, it will become your routine. Even if you don't want, it will be followed by you. But you have to take that, initiation. It's like inertia, okay? We will be suffering from that inertia. We will be stuck into that, our self-created clutches. We have to escape from those clutches. And it requires a lot of hard work, a lot of determination. Every topper, you must have listened to almost many of the toppers. Even I have watched their videos and all. They always tell, and sometimes I have also, wondered what bullshit they are talking. We already know what they are talking. Whatever I am telling, it doesn't mean that you don't know. You already know. The problem is that application of mind and then determination, these are all individual, right? See, for example, Tendulkar has his own set of skills. Okay, he tells his batchmates or his teammates or his juniors how to bat, how to hit the shots and all. But everyone cannot become Sachin Tendulkar. It's a skill. Okay, just like that, administration is also a skill, and that skill is an individualistic skill. Okay, It is not that everyone is very much different in terms of knowledge. Knowledge will be same. Every one of us will read Lakshmikant, Spectrum. It doesn't mean that offers doesn't read some different sources. Everyone will read. How will you apply yourself? That, you know, whatever we tell, right? And some people will be having in their mindset that some toppers will also do it. That is not, you know, even altogether a wrong thing, that some toppers will hide their, you know, strategies. So-called toppers will be there. They will hide it. They will not reveal what they have done. But majority of the toppers, so-called successful candidates in civil services, they will reveal it. Whatever, you know, majority candidates are there, now, they will reveal it. After that also, we will fail to figure out what is this, you know, strategy all about. So, I have told whatever I have done, like solving the test papers, following, you know, NCRT notes, NCRT, you know, books, and then standard reference books. Normal routine, everyone has to do, but with the application of your own mind. That, you know, nobody can teach, right? Like, even the first rankers of last 15 years come and personally tutor you, you will not be knowing it unless until you apply your own mind. That's the reason why this exam becomes very difficult. A lot of people from IITs, IIM, these guys will write this exam. But in terms of knowledge, nobody is inferior, nobody is superior. Everyone is equally capable. But application of mind, that is where, you know, things fall apart. So, based on, you know, experiences of the successful candidates, you should guess, you know, you should extract what is best which that can work for you. And for that, Mrunal.org, toppers, this link is very much helpful. You have to go through this link and then read at least 15 to 20 toppers interviews. Like previous year, you know, successful candidates. Out of which, at least 5 to 6, you know, toppers' strategy will be easily connected with you. Like you can easily figure out, yes, it will work with me. You know, even I am also doing the same thing. And you have to continue the same thing. And it will click for you. Provided if you are honest with yourself and if you complete whatever has been prescribed. Prescription is nothing but those, you know, standard reference books. And mains ke bare mein toh, you have to write the test series. Mains we will discuss some other time. Prelims ke bare mein same hai. Like some people, there is one more disclaimer here. There is absolutely no one way to clear this examination. If there are 796 seats this time, there are 796 seats, ways available. So you have to identify your own comfortable way, okay? And then you have to apply yourself. Like test paper solution, reading standard, these are all the common things. You have to do them and multiple revisions. That is the thing one has to, you know, learn from the experiences of the toppers. And now also I am on a leave, extraordinary leave called EOL after my foundation course training. I want to improve my rank from 307 to single digit, because for general category, if you do not come within, you know, top 70, you will not get into IAS. If you do not come into top 140, 150, you will not get into IPS, like that. So, I have taken a leave to improve my rank. In 100 days, I will do the same things again. I am not, you know, hiding anything. I will do the same routine. Now also, I am doing the same thing. Like, I have already finished, you know, monthly magazine of vision during current affairs. You can, you know, read any of your coaching materials, like Vajram will come up with its own, Sriram its own, everything, any other material. IAS Delhi Institute, they are also starting their own current affairs program. And current affairs program will run like 3 hours per day. You can avail that help. You can refer any one institute's, you know, source. And that is the only, you know, reference point. You should not get diverted again. So, I am reading those things only again. I have completed my economic survey like this. So, I will start solving test series, one test per day in the next 100 days. That means almost I will complete, you know, again 90 to 100 test papers along with their revisions. So, I will do the same things. And it doesn't mean that I will get the success again. It all depends on how that question paper will be, how I will apply myself. Every year it will be very difficult, different, if not difficult. Difference will be there. So we have to adapt to that difference. And now I have told you, I am waking up very late, I am sleeping very late. But when during peak of my preparation, my routine was like this. From morning 9 a.m. to till 12 a.m. in the night, I used to be in the library. And I used to follow one self-identified rule that is called not more than 1 hour away from the library. Whatever you want to do it in your study room. I mean study room in the sense, if you are studying in a room or else if you are studying in library, you should not go away from library for more than 1 hour at any given point of time, for lunch, for breakfast, for tea, for anything. If you go 1 hour away from your library, your productivity will not be satisfactory. From morning 9 a.m. to 12 a.m, if you work like more than 13-14 hours, it doesn't mean that your productivity will be like 10-12 hours. No, it will be somewhere around 7 to 8 hours. Okay. Even if you sit for 14 hours in the library, your productivity will be like 8 hours. So you should consider these all factors. If you go to meet a friend over a cup of tea, coffee, then 2 hours will be gone. You should be mindful of those things. Small course corrections, these things will matter in this UPSC journey. I have interacted with many of the so-called toppers of previous batches this year, my batchmates, everyone. Even though some of the candidates are very brilliant, some of them are like useless. One thing very common among everyone is sheer hard work. Nobody qualifies this examination solely based on luck or solely based on 50% luck, 50% hard work. No. Everyone will have worked very hard. Okay. Some candidates have not qualified in the exam, maybe because of luck factor and all, despite working hard. But we can't do anything about it. But whoever qualifies this examination have one similar thing, that is hard work, intense hard work. You should have that in your mindset. Like you have come to war zone. This is nothing but a war zone. Okay. UPSC preparation is intense war zone. In this war zone, survival of the fittest is the only mantra. And the competition is not with the person sitting beside you. Though examination is a relative examination, this competition is between you and your mind. Your mind is the biggest enemy here. You have to defeat your own self and then conquer your own self on a daily basis by taking each day at a time. You are understanding what I am telling. It's not a motivation or something, nothing, it's just like you have to identify your own weaknesses. For example, I told you 9 a.m. to 12 a.m. I followed it like more than 80-90 plus days during 2017-18 also. I will do this, hopefully I will do the same thing again now also in the remaining 100 days. So in this also, sometimes you will feel very much demotivated, extremely demotivated, like why same cheez padna again and again, Lakshmikant, Spectrum, Economics, Shankar, lots of things to do, there will be lot of confusions. In that confused state, you have to back yourself. How will you back yourself? Okay, whatever it is, I will not waste my time. Even if it is boring, I will do the boring stuff only. I will make it interesting myself. So boring routine you have to follow. There is no other way. And this will teach you, even in the bureaucracy, I am telling you, we will enter this bureaucracy with lots of excitement. Like thinking that IAS will be awesome job, IPS will be awesome job. Bureaucracy's word itself is like routine work. Boredom will automatically creep in your work culture. So this UPSC preparation itself will teach you. Like you have to do the routine things only. Okay, you have to be innovative, you have to be smart, but with those routine things, like you should be innovative with NCRT, innovative with Lakshmikant, innovative with Spectrum. I have seen many people like making notes out of Polity, Lakshmikant and then Spectrum. No need to make notes out of these two books. You have to be smart enough to identify these things. right? Like everyone knows, from NCRT, it is left to an individual based on time whether to make notes or not. But absolutely no need to make exclusive notes based only out of NCRTs. You can underline in the book itself, you can write in the margins itself, right? And also I have identified, observed one more thing. While underlining, some students will not leave anything in the page. They will underline everything. What is the use of underlining if you do like this? I have told many of my friends in library also. I have seen doing underlining everything in the page. It is of no use. You have to be smart enough, like which line to be underlined and which, you know, facts to be highlighted like that. And you will get to know about this by referring last previous 5 years question papers. Previous question papers are very much helpful. And everyone, you must have listened to this. Everyone have told this. Previous year ka question paper refer kar lo. Why? Because there is a fact in that. You should be in such a way that if someone asks which, you know, when did this question, of, you know, came into the UPSC prelims, you should be ready to tell in which area, in which year it came and in which sequence it came. So you should be expert in previous year question papers. Based on that, you will understand what is UPSC's, you know, mentality, what they are willing to know from the candidates. So based on that, you have to identify the underlining of different factual informations. If you look at my Lakshmikant book, not more than 40 to 50% of the page is underlined. That means hitting the bull size. Very important things only you have to underline, and you have to revise those underlined things only during revisions. If you are underlining everything, then revision becomes extremely difficult. Okay, so whatever you read, more than 60-70% underlining is not required. Around 60% is okay, acceptable. So identify those things, and you will come to know about it from the previous question papers, right? And regarding elimination methods and all, elimination method, UPSC usually, unlike test papers, UPSC will give like option one. Only one statement is correct, only one and two is correct, and all of them is correct, and one, two, three is correct out of the four statements, like that. If they give you such, statements, it is very easy to eliminate, okay? Even, and you have to apply this elimination in the first round itself, if they give options like this. But if they give options like one and two, two and three, one, two, three, and like this, where without knowing all of the statements, you cannot take a decision. Such questions you have to attempt at the last, okay? You cannot simply guess and choose this, because in the out of three statements, you will be definitely knowing one and two are correct, and you are very much confused about the third statement. In that case, you will have a chance of 50% probability. Right, the question getting correct is 50% probability, and going wrong is also 50%. So such questions you have to take at the end of the your attempt. Like, you should solve these test papers with iterations, multiple iterations. I think you also know this. You also know about this. Everyone must have told about this. Everyone follow the same thing again. So multiple iteration in the sense, you have to take minimum 4 to 5 rounds to solve the question paper. 4 to 5 rounds. In the last 4 or 5 rounds, you can go for these options, elimination options. In the initial round, even if you solve only 10 questions out of 100, 10 questions out of 100, you have to be 200% certain about what you are doing. Extremely, positive questions only you have to solve. No matter, even if it is only just 10. And then, as the iteration progresses, your guessing things comes into picture. Like after this, 100% sure shot questions, you should go for 4 statement questions. After that, 3 statement questions. After that, 2 statement questions, like this. 2 statement questions are very much difficult, and there will be around 15 to 20 direct questions. like A, B, C, D, there will not be any sentences. So those questions are very much difficult. Either you hit the bullseye or you will get 0 marks, like that. Are you getting it? So you should take these such questions at the end. Okay, you should not, you know, immediately solve them. And one more mistake aspirants do is that marking in the question paper and then copying it in OMR. This is very dangerous thing. You should not leave anything to copy in the last, you know, 10-15 minutes to copy from question paper to OMR sheet. Whenever you come to know that you have taken a decision on this particular question, you should share, you know, in the OMR sheet. You should mark in the OMR immediately. You should not wait. If you wait, many people I have seen, despite, you know, getting many of the questions correct, they have failed to mark in the OMR. And then what is the use of if you don't mark in the OMR? So do not, you know, do that mistakes. Okay. So this is all brief about this, you know, prelims and all. And mistakes, as per the mistakes concerned, I have seen day before yesterday also, I saw one person sitting in library, was reading both Vajramka magazine and then Vision ISK monthly magazine for the current affairs, right? So this is a sure shot way of failure. I have also done this in my 2016 attempt. Okay, I used to read my, you know, institute's current affairs magazine and then Vision ISK magazine, even Vajramka magazine I used to glance through. No point. Our memory pattern works like, you know, for not more than 7 days it will stay in our memory, whatever you read today. So without revisions, whatever you do, it is of no use. Revisions, minimum, you know, 3 to 4 revisions are required to retain our, you know, factual information. So if you are reading any institute's magazines, stick to that. There is absolutely no quality, quantity, nothing. Every, you know, magazine will copy from newspaper itself. Everyone will, you know, it's just a matter of arranging them in the systematic order. Okay, some institute will do that, some institute will just, you know, copy paste and give it to, you know, aspirants. You decide which magazine is better for you. Okay, and follow that only single magazine. And as I told, IAS Delhi is also starting their own current affairs, right? If you want to avail the help from them, you can depend on them. Only one institute, one magazine, okay? That should be your mantra. And for history, modern history, I will read, you know, Spectrum also, I will read Vipin Chandra also. No. Strict no. Instead of reading, you know, 10 different books for one subject, reading one book for 10, you know, times is very much relevant. Only single book. Like this, if you do, you will increase your, you know, probabilities of getting the right answer, and then you will save the time. Time is very precious here, okay? So, and then I forgot to tell you in the beginning itself that you should draw boundary, borderline. This is very crucial actually, and it is very tempting. If you visit any of the Xerox centers here, either Kumar Bookstall or Image Runner, wherever, you will see a plethora of, you know, materials, huge, you know, sets of materials from different, they are very attractive. Page cover, everything, you know, you feel like, okay, it is very important, I have to read that, read this. Some institutes will, you know, release their PT365 compilation, films compilation, exclusive compilation. Then, you know, if you do not have this boundary, you will, you know, take everything out of this, you know, ocean, and you will not be having time to revise any of them.